There are only two sure things in life, death and taxes. Like this poor soul they just brought in here. Obviously, he knows about death. However, something's just not sitting right with me. I'm wondering how many people would try to escape paying taxes by getting put 6 feet into the ground. Like this so-called poor soul. I bet when he was alive, he conveniently forgot to pay his taxes. Or maybe he just did it intentionally. But in my line of work, that's known as a red flag situation. So maybe this poor soul is in line for an audit by me, IRS. And remember, even after they bring your frozen carcass into the funeral home, you still have to pay your taxes.
Well, we're back, but I must say that was a rather sobering thought, wouldn't you say, Jerry Lawler?
Well, I'll tell you, seeing that IRS and the funeral, all it reminded me of my uncle's funeral. He had the most expensive funeral in history.
It's cost
$50,000 so far.
Your uncle's spent...
Well, I mean, someone spent $50,000 of your uncle's money for his funeral?
I said his funeral has cost $50,000 so far.
What do you mean, so far?
Well, we buried him in a rented tuxedo. Get it, big man?
Right.
I want to tell you, nobody escaped paying taxes, and IRS is going to see to that.
Irwin R. Scheister, ladies and gentlemen.
Here we go with Kerry Davis. And who does Kerry Davis remind y'all?
Somebody that the Smoking Guns ought to be real familiar with.
Who's that?
Remember Festus on Gunsmoke?
I thought you were going to Gabby Hayes.
Well, yeah, he does look a little bit like him, too.
Off the rope and over Gabby, right back, drop kick, nicely done.
Or actually, Kerry Davis, not Gabby.
He sure looks like Gabby.
Let me put your cowboy knowledge to the test.
Go ahead.
Who's sidekick was Gabby Hayes?
Sidekick was
Roy Rogers. Roy Rogers, okay.
What was the name of Roy Rogers' horse?
Trigger.
No, that was the name of his wife.
Wait a minute. What was the name of his wife's horse?
Name of his wife's horse?
Yeah, I bet you don't know that.
It rhymed with Trigger.
No, it didn't.
It didn't?
No. Oh. See, and all those idiots out there wonder, King really that smart? Does he know the name of...
look at this, Benova!
Yeah! Does he know the name of Dale Evans' horse?
All right, go ahead. We're going to call the action here, but you're going to give us the name of Dale Evans' horse.
Yeah, this is for real. Buttermilk.
Buttermilk.
That's right.
Have you ever had any buttermilk in your life? You ever tasted buttermilk?
No, wait.
Open all. Look at this now. Oh, there could be some trouble here. Yes. Double neck breaker.
That's what cowboys drink down on the farm, isn't it?
Buttermilk?
Yeah, that clabbered. No way. It's not for me. I'm a king. Yeah. Royalty.
No health food's going to come your way.
Where's Gabby going?
Gabby tagged out. Here comes Tony DeVito. And DeVito's getting a gut-wrench suplex. No!
How about that maneuver?
Ho-ho! DeVito feeling the effect of that as Billy tags in Bart. The Smoking Gun, perhaps.
Tag team championship bound.
They'd love to have a shot at it against Shawn Michaels and the 7-foot Diesel. And DeVito is in trouble. He's in big-time trouble. Look at this going up to the top. All the way from the top of the bunkhouse. Down!
For your information on your cowboy. No?
That's right, but I'm not too impressed with these cowboys. As a matter of fact, I'm going to use my royal magistrator and just show you a little bit of what... Whoa, there's my horse face for you. I'm going to show you what I did. Do you hear a neigh there? She reminds me of old paint. Speaking of old paint, do you remember old paint?
Old paint?
Yeah, take a look at the cowboys here. I'm going to paint a little picture of what they're going to look like if they keep trying to tangle with the heavenly bodies. You see this, McMahon?
Yeah, what is it?
The table upside down.
No, not quite.
Maybe it's mushrooms growing.
No, mushrooms have to be in the dark like you. A John Nagy, you're not. But me, I'm quick on the draw. And this is not old paint. I call it old glue. And that's where they'll be headed, to the glue factory. Once the heavenly bodies get through with them.
Stand by for the live event news.
Promotional consideration paid for by the following.
Welcome back, New York, to Live Event News. I'm Charlie Mann. Are we ready? New York for a triple play? We want to remind you now, the WWF Heart Attack World Tour, Meadowlands Arena this Thursday night, Nassau Coliseum this Friday night, Madison Square Garden Saturday night, October 29th, 1 week from tonight. Be part of the WWF action.
Everybody knows that at this time of year, the powers of the Undertaker are at their strongest. And if you come to the arena dressed like Paul Bearer and sound like him, you could win a fabulous prize. You may even go to Survivor Series. Now let's go to the great WWF Heart Attack World Tour matches. Oh, yes.
Who was that guy? How about the Mr. Bob Backlund Challenge? Can anybody break out of the chicken wing? Duke the Dumpster Drozzi on one side, Erwin R. Scheister on the other. Who do you like in this one? Adam Bomb or Bam Bam Bigelow? Power against power in that one. It's the Smoking Guns. Bart and Billy will try to upend the team of the Heavenly Bodies. Doink will have Dink in his corner. Jerry the King Lawler will have Queasy in his corner. This is a match that had to happen after SummerSlam. Lex Luger and his former friend, Tatanka. Championship match. Can Jim the Anvil Neidhart take the WWF title away from Bret the Hitman Hart? And the unbelievable casket match, Undertaker and Yokozuna. The winner has to throw the loser in a ringside casket and shut the lid. What a, oh, there's that sound again. Where's the Undertaker? Paul? Tickets. You better get the tickets. They will be available at all arena box offices and all Ticketmaster outlets. Now and again, folks, you won't want to miss the two big matches. We got Bret the Hitman Hart against Jim the Anvil Neidhart and the casket match, Yokozuna and Undertaker. Once again, those great dates. Meadowlands Arena this Thursday night, Nassau Coliseum this Friday night, Madison Square Garden Saturday night, October 29th. We complete the hat trick 1 week from tonight.
Next week, ladies and gentlemen, join us for more WWF Superstars in Action. We'll be Double J, Jeff Jarrett, and hopefully he will not be horsing around like you have been all week.
Yeah, well, two guys that are going to be here that are so dumb they think that Shakespeare is a tribal dance, the Head Shrinkers are going to be in action.
Also in hand, ladies and gentlemen, yes, they call him the Anvil because that's the way his head is shaped. Jim the Anvil Neidhart will join us.
And another edition of the Heartbreak Hotel, this time with the Million Dollar Man and his entire corporation.
And joining us as well, he's oozing machismo, it's, yeah, Razor Ramon.